of information and communication technology, or intelligence, whatever you call it, in a modern city or the city of the future is missing. What can we do with all this intelligence, with this information and communication technology? I say, and probably you already do it, the internet, as an example, is not only for getting information anymore. The internet today is for participating. You have a blog, you have a Twitter. If you want to have direct contact with somebody of the government, you can do. You don't have to wait until the next elections. You can really address people. In the meantime, probably we will have elections by internet in the future. Maybe every week, every day. Make our choice, make our participation in something which happens in our city, in our street, in our neighborhood. So information and communication technology, or whatever you call it, it's not about cables. Cables, it doesn't matter. Is it wireless? Is it wired? Is it glass? Is it copper? Doesn't matter. It's about the communications made. And so I put a new layer on top of the urban planning systems. Rethink and think about now what you can do with information and communication technology now and in the future. This is too long. I call this concept open source city, which the open source idea, maybe you know, there is not one owner of, for instance, software or hardware. Everybody can add something to it. You have to keep in mind that somebody did some creative thing, so you don't copy it, you work forward onto the things somebody else has been doing. And the whole computer operating system, Linux, is working on that way of collaborating from people with one another. And you can do it also in town, I think. I addressed 10 items, which I will not elaborate too much on now, but on every level, the energy, the planning, the social shift, so people getting older, at least in Holland, we are getting much, much too old, and there are too less youngsters. In Italy, it's even a bigger problem. If you look at the streets of towns, you only see elderly people. The young ones are moved to the big cities. So there is a social shift. We have a, I think, when we can buy anything from everywhere, there will be a rebound effect. And the rebound effect is that we will get local trade again. You do not know what your neighbors are doing, but maybe he has the stuff you want. Maybe it's somebody else in the street who has the thing you do. You see there is some kind of e-commerce underneath, we call it an electronic marketplace, wherein people exchange and pay a little amount of money to exchange stuff between one another. So you get the local trade. And local trade can even be something you, and you addressed it also, has been doing in his garden. I call it urban farming. So we do not want anymore the non personal touch of grown vegetables. You want to do it yourself, or you want to buy it from somebody you know, who you can trust. From who you know, he respects the earth, he respects the way stuff should grow. So then you can call in also the local trade. I call it hyper-living. Hyper-living is about how our living, our houses in the future will look like. Work balance is about the same, how the work balance in the future will be. Personal spheres has also to do with taking care of people who are sick and old, and private public has to do with the change of the responsibility you take yourself. Not wait until the private the public sector comes into action. I presume, I expect in 20 years' time, maybe you own your own street again, together with your neighbors. You decide, you say to the government, give us back our street. It's our street. We decide how it looks like. We keep on servicing the green. We know how to design it. We do it with ourselves. I think we will take back the things which belong to one another and in which we cooperate with our neighbors, that we will get it back. And of course, all these stuff which have to come in and out of a city has to be organized, and which that I call smart flows. So I won't keep you on all these texts. It's nice to read maybe later on if you're interested. Maybe I can tell you about it. But there is a lot of things changing in time. And I think with putting more intelligence, using the potential of intelligence and information and computer technology, we can add a layer to the city with which the whole city will look different in future. One of the products I designed next to that is a kind of what you call an electronic street nameplate. And the street nameplate, do you ever look at your own street nameplate? You know what a street nameplate? It says on the street in which street you live. Do you ever use it? No, you never use it. Only others will use it. So perhaps that location, that spot, that place can be used for things you want to share with your neighbors. So address, you're looking for a babysitter, or there's a house sale somewhere there, or there are new neighbors coming, a few houses from there. You can use the same spot and use it as a new kind of community thing. Everybody can use it, everybody can have access to it. And as you see, I didn't do it in one day, I did it in several days to rethink this. You can put it on the internet, you can put it on your mobile phone, and there is a whole idea about it, where to use it even more. You can even use it as a kind of TomTom. Now you have your TomTom in your car built, but if you say to somebody, some neighborhood you're entering, I'm coming in, maybe the street nameplate can guide you to the place you're coming. Okay. I want more thing, which urges me also. What is a green city? And if you look at, for instance, the town of Rotterdam, it also finds itself, or needs to be, green itself. But as you know, in Rotterdam, we have the highest buildings in the Netherlands. And I think, and probably you agree with me, you stop making high-rise buildings. So the problem with high-rise buildings is that you have to get everybody onto solar energy. But if there is a huge building in front of you, you'll never get any solar energy because of the high-rise building in front of you. So there one day, maybe not now, maybe not in 10 years, maybe in 20 years, everybody can by law ask for his right to get sunlight so he can have the sun heat up his heater or make energy from his solar panel. Everybody has to have the right to make his own energy. So stop making too high buildings. Thank you very much, and I hope you will address it some way.
Still the same people. Yeah. Thank you very much, Marcel, and we're all here. We all stayed, I think, because we are fascinated by your, how do you say, your campaign for using intelligence above all other materials and resources that we're used to in creating. It's cheap and it's there. Thanks a lot. Which brings us to the end of the opening of the Green Design Festival. I'm really happy that so many people still stayed. I think this was a great example of the concentration and the high level that we're going to see over the next few days. Drinks are being offered by the Green Design Festival and the Dutch Embassy next door. The speakers are available for the journalists and the media which are still present. And maybe finally I'd like a round of warm applause for Germana over there. She's a spectacle in herself to watch her translate, and it was tough, and you did a great job. Thank you very much. So let's have a drink.